The Dred Scott decision, which was handed down by the Supreme Court in 1857, is one of the most famous or infamous decisions in all of the history of the Supreme Court. And it arose out of some complicated issues, but what it basically had to do with was the power of Congress to prohibit slavery in the Western territories. Dred Scott had been brought as a slave into the territory of Wisconsin, where slavery had been barred by Congress. And later he sued for his freedom on the ground that he had been in a place where slavery had been abolished and therefore should be considered free. And this goes all the way up through various courts, and the Supreme Court eventually rules no, Dred Scott's not free because two reasons. One, Congress does not have the right to prohibit slavery in the territories, and this basically declares the Republican Party unconstitutional. The Republican platform, Lincoln's platform, which is to prohibit slavery in the territories, the Supreme Court said you can't do that. Slavery is a right to go anywhere within the country in a territory, not a state. A state can abolish slavery, Illinois did, but the territories which belong to the whole country, slavery is a right to go there. The second principle put down by Chief Justice Taney in the Dred Scott decision was that blacks cannot be citizens of the United States. In a sense, Dred Scott can't even sue because he's not an American. This is one of the best examples of this notion of blacks as aliens. Even though he's born here and everything, he is not an American. The American family, as Taney says, is for white people. And in the most famous sentence in that decision, he says, a black man has no rights which a white man is bound to respect. Now, he's not saying blacks can be killed with impunity. What he's saying is, legally speaking, they are not part of the body politic. They are not part of the we the people that created the Constitution, and therefore they're just outside of the system. So they don't have any rights under the Constitution because the Constitution is for white people. Now, this, people have denounced Taney ever since for this, and for good reason, but the fact is this decision was codifying widely held views in American society, North and South. You're blaming the messenger in a sense if you simply hold the Chief Justice responsible for these views. But it's certainly the position that Congress could not stop the westward spread of slavery discredited the Supreme Court in the eyes of large numbers of Northerners, including Lincoln. Lincoln is denouncing them after this and saying, Lincoln, who is a law-abiding guy, says we don't have to recognize this decision. We're going to ignore it. It's a bad decision. And when the Republicans get in, we are not going to abide by the Dred Scott decision. So it shows you how far the sectional dispute has gotten that a guy like Lincoln will say the ruling of the Supreme Court can just be ignored because it's so wrong-headed.